Jeffrey and his chinglingue self and his dirty shoe. Come in, chop you free.
Dear Jasmine, I wonder if this love is everlasting. I promise not to treat you like your last.
Hi, babes. Hi, boo boo. Hi, darling. Hi, guys, and welcome back to another video. First off, before I even get started, it is 12:42 a.m. Yes, I decided to waste the entire day sleeping, eating. I've come to sit here so light that I'm shooting video. Either way, we are still going to shoot it. I have work at 7 a.m. Then I have to wake up around 5. By the time I finish this video, it's probably going to be like 1:30. It's going to be an interesting day. Have you seen my hair? Yeah, I just shot that one too this evening. I'm being very, very productive. Even though the first half of the day, I was useless. You've done well. Anyway, today's video, I went to Instagram and I asked you guys, what kind of sit down videos do you want me to do? Some of you suggested that I do a Q&A and a bunch of other things as well. No, where are they going at 12:44 a.m.? Okay, I think we're good. Let's get right into the video. Some of you gave me a few questions and I have them on my laptop. So I'm just gonna go ahead and answer that. But of course, today is not pineapple juice and it's not a fruit juice. Today we are really having wine. Why not? Kasa kasa, which is good because right after this video, mekoda. And this is Bartinura. Where do you see yourself living long term? So I see myself living in Ghana long term, to be honest, but I want to be here for a while to make all the money I can make so that I will take the money into Ghana, change it to Ghana cedis, then I become billionaire. That's my long-term plan, okay? That's where I want to live in Ghana. Here is for the making of the money. Ghana is for the relaxing and the peace of mind. This is funny. Somebody's asking me what body cream I use, and I use Neutrogena Hydro Boost. This is what I use. How do I stay motivated? That's an interesting question. I look at my situation, the fact that I know I can do so much better than I'm currently doing keeps me motivated. I'm always thinking like, okay, if by next year I have this, that'll be great. If by next 2 years I have this, that'll be amazing. So we have to work towards it. We have to keep going. I'm constantly thinking about what I am doing, what my next step is every time, in my sleep, in my dream, in my eat, in my everything. Yeah. Somebody's asking my favorite song at the moment, and it is Faves Mr. Man and what is this guy's name? Is it called Zuga? Snapchat. Hey. Easy takes me on Snapchat. Sexy snaps me out, beating like rap chat. Cause in my quality bed, quality rest is rest that short for you. And then this song as well. Things you cannot say with your mouth. You say with your hands, I respond. DJ, could you play me, Mr. Man? Record a little dance on the floor. Okay, if I put this song in this video and I get copyrighted, whoever asked me that question, I'm fighting with you. What Ghanaian dish have you enjoyed so far in Canada? Probably jollof rice. I have been eating a lot of that, and that jollof rice, Salma introduced me to it. It is so expensive. It's really good. So I have been eating that a lot. Honestly, bankutu. I can't wait to go to Ghana and eat kinky. Hey, listen, when I finally land in Ghana, all the new places that are opening that people are signing line to go and eat. Catch me there. I have to really eat a lot of food. There are so many that I haven't had in a while. I can't wait. I simply can't wait. Have you ever been on birth control? I have. I was having a few issues with my monthly cycle. Like, I wasn't getting my period every month. It was like every other month, maybe every 2 months, every 3 months, which was weird and which wasn't normal. So I went to the hospital and they said it was probably stress in my diet. So they put me on birth control for a while. I was actually supposed to keep taking it, but I stopped taking it because I cannot make it myself. And that was the only instance that I have been on birth control. I'm actually
terrified of it for some reason. I think I need to do more research. That's it. Has it been, I'm guessing easy is there, has it been easy making girlfriends as an adult? Not really, because especially here everybody is pretty much busy. The time that I also came was just not favorable for me to even be making friends in the first place, because you know, COVID, the pandemic, it's just a whole lot. Even though I'm a very very friendly person, there are a lot of people that I have met, I haven't been able to keep up with them because everybody is just living and kind of busy. I've made a few friends, just a few of them, not as many as I would want to. Now that things are starting to open up and you know, you're not even going to be wearing masks anymore, like hopefully you guys are going to be seeing other faces on my channel other than myself and Salma. Life is too short to not have friends. I want tons and tons of friends, and I don't think making friends as an adult is actually hard, because you know the type of people that you vibe with. It's all about the vibes for me now. If I click with someone instantly, that's about it. Like the way I click with Salma, instantly the vibe was just unmatched. How do you manage your finances in Canada? Too much taxes. Am I really managing it? I have budgeting apps, I have savings accounts, I have like, I literally sit down and plan what to put away, what to spend. It's getting easier, but I'm not there yet. So I'm not the best person to answer this question, I promise you, because it's in shambles. We're trying to do something, but it's not quite working. Because sometimes I'll be like, okay, this money, let me divide it into 5. Put some in the savings, I'll put some in this one, and I'll put some in the chocolate. Like, I'll divide it, but then at the end of the day, that savings will be calling onto my name because my mouth has bagayas. And I just want to chop, 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 chop. Ever use a handkerchief as a sanitary towel because of emergency? Not a handkerchief, but toilet paper. And I think a lot of people have done it before. There's some emergencies that you don't have some around you. Toilet paper is your best friend. What else are you going to do? Handkerchief saying, never used handkerchief before. I don't think so, no. Toilet paper for sure. Toilet paper, yes. A lot of it. Like, you roll it like 5 billion times. So you can, you know, get a sanitary towel somewhere. It's so funny. Somebody wants to know the equipment I use in shooting my YouTube videos and what software I edit with. So I have, right now as I'm shooting, I have my softbox, which I bought on Amazon. I'm gonna put it on the screen. It's amazing, it's bright enough, you guys can see me. And I also have like a phone stand that I also got from Amazon, and I shoot with my phone. And for editing, I edit my videos with Final Cut Pro. I used to edit with Adobe Premiere, which is also a good app. I feel like Adobe is a little bit complicated compared to Final Cut Pro. What are your thoughts on interreligious marriage? Growing up in such a situation as well, because my parents are interreligious, so it wasn't the easiest because I didn't know which side I was. I didn't know if I wanted to go to the mosque or I wanted to go to church, and it confused me a lot so many times, because then I had to play two roles where if I go to my grandma's side and she's going to the mosque, I have to follow her. Because I was young, I was like, I think 9 years or so, or 10. And when I go to school, or if I am like back home, I go to church. When somebody asked me, are you a Christian or a Muslim, I didn't know what to say. I always said half. I feel like unless the parents agree on how they want to bring up the child in one religion rather than just leave it to the child. In fact, there was this time in school they asked us to write my church. It was supposed to be an essay. That time I don't think I had even started going to church yet. I think I was in class 5 or so. Everybody assumed that I was Christian. When they said we should write my church, I didn't have church, so I went to my teacher and I went to tell my teacher that I go to the mosque. My teacher said if I'm going to the mosque, then I should write my mosque. How am I come to write my mosque? Because the mosque doesn't have name. The one I knew didn't have name. It was just so basalicious. I had to make up lies for that essay. I didn't know what the hell I was writing. But I support interreligious marriage 100%. Listen, do whatever you want. It doesn't matter to me. As long as you hold your beliefs, who cares? The one person you miss so much in Ghana. One person. Because I miss so many people in Ghana. I'm trying to think between all the people that I miss, who can I mention? My baby niece, Rama, she is adorable. I miss her so much because I feel like by the time I see her, she'll be all grown and not a baby anymore. I think I miss her the most. I miss her the most. Have you ever thought of quitting YouTube? Countless times. Countless times. I have had a couple of thoughts like that, but I quickly brush it off because I know I can do it. All these thoughts about quitting is just because I'm exhausted and I get stressed a little bit. Now I don't think I want to stick it at all. What's a terrible habit you genuinely feel you need to stop but always fall back into? Keeping in touch with people I care about. I am terrible at it. Salma will tell you, Jasmine will tell you, my parents will tell you, my sister will tell you. Everybody close to me will tell you that I am terrible at keeping in touch. It's not because I don't care. I occupy myself so much and I'm always in my little space that I forget that there are people around. And I really want to change that. I hate it when my friends say, hey, you there, you don't check up on me, car. Or, hey, you there, unless I call you, you won't call me. I really hate the way I like to be around people. I should be able to check up on them. No, yeah. I need deliverance from Jesus. I actually have a lot of people that I have to call. Do you buy all your hair you receive, or they're usually for free? I don't think I've ever bought hair, like a wig, in my entire life. Since I started wearing wigs, I've never bought a wig, which I am very, very grateful for. How do you deal with insecurities? I don't deal with it. I know I can't change them, so I might as well just embrace them. I think what I do is hype myself up by telling myself it's not that bad. For instance, my legs, instead of it to be like this, that's my legs. Do you get what I mean? Like, everybody's legs is like this. My own legs are like this. Some people call it knock knees. In school, they used to call me wide legs. When you see me in person, I'm walking. It's so funny. I don't think a lot of people know that. And it's something that I'm constantly thinking about. Like, when somebody's looking at me, I'm like, are they looking at my legs? Or are they looking at my face? Which one? What am I going to do? Cut the legs and throw it away. Do you have working hours limit? Yes, as an international student, you can only work 20 hours a week. Typically, people work 40 hours. When you have a study permit, you can only work 20 hours a week. People do break the rules though, but ultimately you're supposed to work 20 hours a week. What are some things you would wish to advise your younger self? That boy that you are with, that boy that you are with right now, you think you're in love. Look at you, perfect, idiot. Are you blinding? That's the first thing I tell myself. Secondly, you did chop money, nyafu. Anything you see, make a buy. Anything, I buy. You know, safe. What's wrong with you? Hey, everything you see must you buy. My friend, better stop that attitude. And you better start saving. You hear me? If I could go back in time, I would tell my younger self to not rush. Don't even let anything make you sad. You think it's adulthood that you have freedom to enjoy. My dear, you better start enjoying yourself before it gets here. You hear me? I'm even annoyed at my younger self. Do you feel like you chose the wrong school by going to Toronto School of Management? 100%. Yes, I feel like I could have done a lot more research and not waste money, because honestly, to me, it was a waste of money. Because at the end of the day, I'm still in another school and I still had to pay even more than I paid in TESOL. So yeah, for sure. How many times have you cried yourself to sleep, and how do you deal with that? How many times? I've done that a few times. I won't say it's plenty, but I have done it a few times, because some days I'm just like, Lord, why? I am tired. In fact, take me to La La Land. Especially when I first came here. Oh, la la la. La 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 la. Now I think it's much, much better. A lot of people that are close to me know that I am actually excellent at hiding my emotions. You would not even know that there's something going on with me. I have learned to talk myself out of it. It's just something that I didn't know I even had, but now I've been doing. Would you come back to Ghana permanently? Yes, I would. What do you consider cheating in a relationship? The obvious one, having sex with somebody else. To me, flirting is cheating. Why are you flirting with other people? The big obvious things, you're kissing somebody, you're having sex with somebody else, you're constantly talking to somebody else as if you are interested in the person. There's a whole list of them. What age is it good to lose your virginity, apart from saying wait till marriage? Listen, keep it. They're not worth it. They are not worth it. I can't give you an age. If you do at an early age, you will regret it. When you grow up, that's when you will see correct man that will treat you like a princess. And then little Afolabi and Kofi and Yao, Jeffrey and his chinglingy self and his dirty shoe, come in, chop you free. When you finish, you go and chop Linda. Me then be joking. I think I'm gonna end it here, guys. It is 1:35 a.m. I have to wake up at 5 a.m. How I will do this, me myself, I don't know. So I'm gonna go ahead and end this video here. I hope you guys enjoyed it. This was actually pretty fun. There are a lot more that I could have answered, but I need to go to bed. I will probably do another video answering all the other questions that I got. Thank you for joining me. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you are new to my channel, if you're new to my channel, babe, listen, what are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that subscribe. Babe, come on. Go ahead. Go ahead and subscribe because you see, when I sing, angels dance. So that means my voice is heavenly. I am singing for you. I may be singing for angels. I'm singing for you. And you won't subscribe? The angels that I'm supposed to sing for, they'll come and carry you. Yeah. If you're also not following me on my social media pages, please go ahead and do. They're going to be at the end of this video. My Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, Snapchat, all of that is going to be at the end of this video. And I will see you guys on another video. Because at this point, my eyes say, tinininini, ting 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 ting, it's closing, guys. Lara, I will see you on another video, okay? Bye, my loves. Bye, love you.